Welcome to ECE3300 at the University of Utah. In lab number 4, we're going to be using the finite difference time domain method to analyze the voltage and current on a transmission line. The finite difference time domain method is a numerical method that's used to solve the telegrapher's equations in the time domain. This method is particularly useful if you want to analyze a transmission line that has a lot of variance in the RLGC parameters along its distance. This is also a very useful method for being able to visualize the voltages and the currents. The Fdtd method is based on two major concepts. One is the finite difference concept and the other is the time domain concept. Let's first examine the finite difference concept. Let's suppose that we have a voltage that varies as a function of z along the transmission line. And let's suppose that it varies something like this. Here is z, and here is a plot of our voltage. If we wanted to do the derivative as a function of z, we've learned to do that in calculus and differential equations, but it's not always easy. We can use a numerical method to go back, and instead of doing a derivative, we're going to go back to the difference form. Now we know that the derivative is giving us the slope of the line. So the way we're going to find the slope of the line is to take two samples at points A and point B. This sample right here is VA, and this one right there is VB. The distance between them is delta z long. Delta z is given in meters. Now the slope of the line at VA is something like this. The slope of the line at VB is a little bit less, and the slope of the line here in the center is given there. If we wanted to approximate this derivative, we could say that the slope of the line is VB minus VA divided by delta z. But which of these three slopes would we be representing? This slope right here is typically called the forward difference. This is often called the backward difference. And the one here in the center is typically called the central difference. The best representation for VB minus VA over delta z is in fact the central difference formula, which means if I have two points, VA and VB, and I represent the slope of them, the slope between them like this, then the derivative that I am representing is right here in the center in between VA and VB. We're going to use this finite difference idea to represent four derivatives in our telegrapher's equations. We're going to represent dV as a function of z, the derivative of the current as a function of z, the derivative of the voltage as a function of time, and the derivative of current as a function of time. Now let's look at what we mean by the time domain form. These are the telegrapher's equations in the time domain. We can see that they're in the time domain because of the derivatives that they have as a function of time. These two equations must be solved simultaneously because the voltage and current generate each other as they move down the transmission line. We can see this is not a static situation because there is in fact variability or variance derivative with respect to time. We're going to use a notation here that I want to explain in some detail. The transmission line is given as a function of z, and I'm going to sample my voltage and my current at various points along this transmission line. Each cell or subcell in this transmission line is going to be delta z long. If I want to know exactly where I am in meters, I'm going to take an index, which I'll call small k, and multiply that by delta z, and that's going to give me my distance z in meters. K is going to go from 1 to big K, which means when you get to the end here, your total length, the total length of the transmission line, is going to be capital K times delta z. We're going to model the time domain axis going down like this, where each of the samples is going to be delta t long, delta t given in seconds. If I want to know what my time is in seconds, I'm going to multiply an index n times delta t, and that's going to give me my time in seconds. Down here at the end, t is going to be n, large n, times delta t. So I can model any space using the integer k and any time using the integer n.